Malls across America are failing, many of them closing their doors. But the Mall of Abilene continues to thrive, celebrating 40 years today. KRBC's Kelsey Pittman explains how the mall has helped local businesses in the city of Abilene grow.
March 14, 1979, the Mall of Abilene opened its doors. Now, 40 years later, 8 stores remain from that opening.
Our occupancy is well in the 90s, and it exceeds a lot of the malls that are of this type of size of marketplace.
One being El Chico.
The mall has been able to keep us afloat.
Cesar Rangel was 15 years old on opening day, working as a cook making chips.
I was always up to being some bit of a prankster, and I would get my sopapilla dough balls, and I would throw them against the wall, and they would stick up there. Well, one day, someone told on me. The mall manager comes out and says, "Cesar, who did that?" I looked at him and said, "It wasn't me."
Now he's the owner, seeing generations of family come in with their own stories to tell.
I used to come here back when I was a little boy with my parents or my grandparents. And now they're mom and dads, they got their kids in college, and they're still coming in.
Seeing a lot of changes over the years. One recent change, the renovated mall cinema, which increased traffic flow.
Hey, I've only got 30 minutes because my movie's starting, but I wanted to get a quick outfit or I want to get a quick gift, you know. We hear people say they're going to the movie all the time.
Buckethead's coming to the mall 10 years ago, saying it was the best decision they made.
It was a great decision. I mean, we never looked back, never regretted coming to the mall at all.
Other malls contacting them to come there, but Nancy says even the bigger cities are nothing like the Mall of Abilene.
I have no plans ever to move out of this mall. They have done the things that take care of the businesses that are in the mall, make them happy to be here.
In Abilene, Kelsey Pittman, KRBC, Abilene's local news.
I sit alone most every night, watch those trains pull out of sight. Don't I wish they were carrying me back to Abilene, my Abilene.
Abilene, Abilene, prettiest town I've ever seen. Women there,
crowded city, there ain't nothing free, nothing in this town for me. Wish to the Lord that I could be in Abilene, sweet Abilene.
Abilene, Abilene, prettiest town I've ever seen. Women there,
and then I only have one more request, and if that's right by that Books a Million where we came in, if we can stop so I can get a shot of the mall entrance, that would be perfect then.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to Abilene, Texas. Welcome to the Mall of Abilene. In this video, I thought I would do things a little bit differently instead of doing the traditional vaporwave music that I enjoy using so much. I figured with the great mood that I was in when I visited this mall and when I was editing this video, I figured I would go a little bit of a different route and actually use a song that is special to Abilene and actually enjoyable to me. And, well, I just thought it worked, and I really liked it, so I hope you did too. But anyway, we're here at the Mall of Abilene. We visited this mall on a whim. Kayla's mother took us for a day trip out to Abilene to go to this restaurant that we really enjoyed. And we went to a couple of different little places, including a little antique store that I really liked. And just out of nowhere, we decided to stop at the mall. And at first, I wasn't even going to film this place, but I was really in love with the aesthetics at it. Even though it's not the biggest mall, I really like the aesthetics here, and I said, you know what? What the heck? Let's do it. Let's have some fun. So I figured, just for fun, I'll do something a little bit different for this video while still providing you guys something I hope you find enjoyable. Anyway, getting into the history of Abilene Mall, or the Mall of Abilene, rather. The mall was built in 1977, that's when development started, and it opened in March of 1979. It costed over $28 million to develop, and as you could see in the opening clip, the mall celebrated its 40th anniversary in 2019. The mall originally opened with Dillard's, JCPenney, Sears, H.J. Wilson Company, later becoming Service Merchandise, and which is now the second Dillard store, and Grissom's, which later became Dunlap's, and is now split between Best Buy, Books A Million, and Ulta. Those were the anchor stores. Some original inline tenants would include Chick-fil-A, Express, GNC, El Chico, which to this day is still open, Foot Action, Motherhood Maternity, Spencer's, and Zales, all of which been at the mall for at least 40 years. As the years progressed, the makeup of these tenants have partially changed. At one point, Grissom's was replaced by Dunlap's. Wilson's would reopen as Service Merchandise in 1985. Later on, tenants like Ulta Beauty and Chuck E. Cheese would occupy the two spaces next to the main entrance, with the vacant Luby's becoming Ulta. In December of 2018, Sears announced that they would be closing and ended up closing in March of 2019, ending its 40-year run at this place. When we look at the JCPenney here, you see the aesthetics of this place, and it kind of goes throughout this whole mall here. You'll see later on in the clip of the Sears, the shot of the Sears closing from 2019. The mall was developed by Paul Broadhead. Management is Jones Lang LaSalle. The owner is also Jones Lang LaSalle. The number of stores and services provided at the mall is 80. The number of anchor tenants is 6, which 5 of them are in use. 1 is vacant, being the Sears. And the total retail area for the mall is just over 680,000 square feet. It's not the largest mall I've been to, but it's also not the smallest either. It's one floor. There's enough space for over 3,600 vehicles to come here for people to enjoy. Obviously, when we were here, it was mid-May, so not every store had reopened from the coronavirus lockdown and shutdowns. When we were here, though, at the time, masks weren't required, so you'll see a lot of people not wearing them. Since then, things have changed in Texas where people are now required to wear them, so that was just how it was then. But at the time, again, not every store was open, but the mall was open for us to enjoy, and I was able to enjoy walking around it and taking it in, and actually made a couple of purchases while we were there. I thought it was a very nice mall. It's not a dead mall by any means. The mall is actually flourishing quite well, and based on what people have said, not only in the video clip you saw at the beginning, but people I spoke to, they're very happy here. This is the premier shopping destination in the Abilene area and actually serves a purpose for over 22 counties, I believe, in the area. So people from all over come to this mall. It's a very busy one as well, and you can see the success in it as the restaurant El Chico is still in business to this day. I thought that was a heartwarming story because not a lot of businesses make it that long, and especially in malls, which, as we all know, is a dying breed. The owners of the Mall of Abilene know how to do it. They're doing it right. I saw a lot of success in this place and can't wait to visit this mall again in the future. Again, I really like the aesthetics here. I like the colors. It was different. And that's something I noticed about malls down in Texas compared to those up here in the Northeast and New England. For some reason, the aesthetics just seem to be a little different, and it's something I really like a lot. This is one of those examples right here. I just, even though it's simple, I really liked it, especially the colors. So, very busy too. We were here on a weekday, and there's the shot of the Sears, by the way. You'll see a clip of that later with a photo showing it closing in 2019, as I had mentioned. But yeah, even for a weekday and just after the virus lockdowns, it was actually quite busy. So doing some of these shots where you see no people in them was actually quite hard. It took me several tries to do it because I like to try and do my mall footage without getting people's faces in them if I can help it. Sometimes you can't, but I like to try and get footage without people in there so you can actually see the mall in its entirety. Sometimes it's difficult when people are in the shot. They kind of block the views, and while there's just nothing I can do about it, I try to do the best to avoid that. So hopefully you're able to enjoy this. I'm very disappointed over the Sears, by the way. I really wish it was open. I would have loved to have seen it in person. I saw a couple of pictures of it from it being open, but that wasn't meant to be. As we know, Sears and Kmart are basically at the end of the ropes, and by 2021, from what I am understanding, they are going to close, just like this store did. However, based on the success of this mall, that just leaves room for improvement and room for another anchor to move in. Imagine if Boscov's did that. I don't see that happening since they're a Pennsylvania, New York, and Ohio, and Maryland chain, but it's just wishful thinking. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed me narrating and enjoy the rest of this video. Instead of giving you guys vaporwave, I'm going to let you guys enjoy the sounds of George Strait, the King. All right, everybody, stay awesome. Bye-bye.
Texas highway land, far beyond my wildest dreams. But I'll turn out the lights tonight. Say goodnight, but not goodbye. I'll be somewhere down in Texas. Drinking.
clear.